is the power, yours is the glory forever. Amen. Nothing will steal your glory. Nothing will steal your glory. Nothing will undermine the blood you shed on that cross. Nothing will steal your glory. Nothing will steal your glory. Nothing will undermine the blood that you shed, Jesus. Nothing will steal your glory. Nothing will steal your glory. Nothing will undermine the blood that you shed. Oh, Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, get your glory. Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, get your glory. Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, get your glory. Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, get your glory. Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, get your glory. Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, get your glory. Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, get your glory. Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, get your glory. Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, get your glory. Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, get your glory. Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, get your glory. Jesus, get your glory. King Jesus, let heaven come. 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 We want to hear the sound. Wanna hear the sound of angels singing. Of all crying holy, of all crying glory to the one, the only one found worthy. Thank you. tribe and tongue. Oh, sing glory to the risen one. We will cry glory. We will cry. Tribe and tongue, sing glory to the risen one. We will cry, holy, holy, glory, glory, till every nation, tribe and tongue. To the risen one. Oh, glory. Glory. To every nation, tribe, and tongue, come and reveal the glorious one. We long to cry glory. We long to cry glory. Made to cry glory. We were made to cry glory. This is us, fully alive, fully alive, as we were made to cry glory. To cry glory. We were made 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 to cry glory. draw near to you. Pull on the strings of my heart, for I long to respond to you. Draw near to me, for I have drawn near to you. And pull on the strings of my heart, for I long to respond to you. For I long to respond to you. Connected to the vine, let me receive all that you have, 'cause you said, Jesus, you said that if we don't let you wash our feet, then we can have no part in you. So let me receive, just let me receive all that you have, all that you have for me. Let me receive, just let me receive all that you have for me. I'll get out of the way, I'll get out of the way, if I am what's blocking you from coming in your fullness, from pouring out your fullness. I'm getting out of the way, I'm getting out of the way. So come and have your way, come and have your way. I want all that you have for me. I want all of it, all of it, all of it, all of it. Tapping into my eternal source, I'm tapping into the eternal source, 'cause you never run dry, you never run dry. Strong, when I have nothing, when I am parched, when I am dry, you never fail, you never fail. Was your strength all along? It was your strength all along. Even what I had thought was my own was your strength all along. Was your strength and grace all along? Somehow you say there's no better place for me to be right here, broken at your feet. Thank you.
Father, thank you for coming and establishing your kingdom here, being in our midst, God. Father, we want you to have your way, for you to receive all the glory. Thank you, Lord, for receiving us in our brokenness, God, and knowing us so thoroughly and completely, and loving us just the way we are. God, you're so good. Thank you, God, for building your kingdom, the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven, here in this place as we gather in this house, God, at New Philly, in our lives and in our families, God. We give our lives to you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. At this time, we will transition into a time of reflecting on God's word and worshiping and praying through God's word. Today's passage comes from Matthew chapter 5, verses 3 to 10. So I encourage you to open your Bibles and just read along with me and to pray and to seek God and let God's word have its way in our hearts. Again, that's Matthew chapter 5, verses 3 to 10. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Father, thank you so much for teaching us what it means to be blessed in the kingdom of heaven, that your ways are higher than our ways, God. And they are higher, Father, than any human reasoning. Father, that your ways are worthy, Father God, of our obedience and our surrender. Father, thank you for letting your word have its way in our hearts and in our lives, God. Father, and we take a hold of all your promises. Thank you for teaching us, God, the ways of the kingdom of heaven, that you say that you give the kingdom of heaven, you give your perfect comfort, which surpasses any kind of reasoning. Father, you give the earth as an inheritance. Father, and we want to receive all of your promises, God. Thank you for paying the price so that we can share in what belongs to you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for teaching us your ways, God. Teaching us that we can be poor in spirit, that we can be humble and not seek our own ways, God, not be wise in our own understanding, but that, God, when we humble ourselves and we submit to you, that, God, you give us the kingdom of heaven. You give us an inheritance. You call us into reigning with Christ. Father, and we mourn before sin. We're not afraid to look at the brokenness in the world and really intercede, God, and to mourn for the sin that we see in the world, mourn for the death and the destruction that we see, God, and to intercede, God, and to believe you, Lord, and to be comfort, God, to be channels of comfort to a broken world. And Father, for our own sin, that we can have godly sorrow, that we can really mourn before you, God, because we know that this leads to repentance and it brings salvation and leaves no regret. Father, we thank you for showing us how to be members of the kingdom of heaven. Father, we exalt your ways, God.
As we humble ourselves and we say we are poor, we are poor, we will see your kingdom.
What blessing we've received. What comfort we've received. We give it up, we give it up.
We give it out. It was never meant to stay with us. Never meant to stop at us. Never meant to stay just here. But it was meant to be poured out. Meant to be poured out. Such is the kingdom of heaven. Joy for all you pour out.
You mourn with us, you mourn with us, and you comfort us. Ooh. You mourn with us, you mourn with us. You don't leave us by ourselves. You mourn with us. You mourn with us. You comfort us with your presence, God.
So I am not alone.
That we need. Look to you for the strength that we need.
We look to you and blessed are we for being weak when we are weak. Blessed are we when we ask, when we seek.
When all is stripped away, everything we rely on, that's when we stripped away everything we want. That's when we see our great inheritance.
It's in our need. It's in our need. We can see your strength. It's in our need. It's in our need that we see your strength, that we see your strength.
Oh, when we are meek, when we are meek, and we lay ourselves down against the ways of the world that say, hold on to your pride. pride when we go against the grain, when we embrace our meekness. Oh, we will see that we have the greatest strength, the greatest inheritance in you. Inheritance in you.
When we see
blessed indeed, we are 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 blessed strength for us, more than we need, more than we need.
You're creating space as we let go. You're creating space. Oh, come and have your way. My inheritance, the fullness of my inheritance.
I will lift my hands to only you. I will receive from you alone. Turn
my eyes, I turn my eyes to the Lord to receive, to see what He has for me, to see what He has for me.
Oh, blessed are we, blessed are we indeed, blessed are we. Blessed are we indeed.
Verse 6. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall receive mercy. Father, we hunger and we thirst for righteousness. Father, the ways and the glory of this world do not satisfy. They are so temporary that even the best rewards on this earth pale in comparison to your glory, to who you are, to your presence, to your righteousness and your justice, God. Father, we wait upon you. We hunger and thirst for righteousness. We hunger and we thirst for your ways, for your wisdom, for the purity of your righteousness, God. We wait for it. We long to see it, not only in our lives, not only in our personal world, but Father, in our communities, God, in this nation, in our generation, God. We hunger and we thirst for righteousness, to see your kingdom come around us. And you promise that we will be satisfied, that you will come like the rain, and in the waiting and in the seeking, you come and you fill us, that you fill the space when we make room for you, God, when we surrender to you, that God, you fill our generation with righteousness. Father, we hunger and we thirst for it, Lord. God, and we will wait and we will intercede and we will seek you until we see it, God, among us, until the kingdom of heaven is established. God, we hunger and we thirst for you and your ways. We thank you, Father.
And we won't fall.
righteousness. You give us righteousness. You give us righteousness. And you'll give us righteousness. 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 Oh, as we won't settle, 'cause we won't settle. And you honor our hunger. You honor our thirst. Lord, you honor our hunger for righteousness. You honor our hunger. You honor our thirst. You honor our hunger for righteousness. Oh, you honor our hunger. You honor our thirst. You honor our hunger for righteousness. You honor. And with this comes a revelation of Christ. Revelation of Christ. Crucified to bring me life, to bring me into this righteousness, to clothe me with new garments, to clothe me in righteousness, to call me righteousness. Of God in Christ, the righteousness of God in Christ, the righteousness of God in Christ. I am the righteousness of God in Christ, the righteousness of God in Christ, the righteousness of God in Christ. I am the righteousness of God in Christ. The righteousness of God in Christ, the righteousness of God in Christ. I am the righteousness of God in Christ, the righteousness of God in Christ, the righteousness of God in Christ. I am the righteousness of God in Christ. The righteousness of God in Christ, the righteousness of God in Christ. This is my new name. 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 My new name. This is my new name. This is my new name. This is my new name. Oh, I am the righteousness of God, the righteousness of God. For it
satisfy my soul. To free me, satisfy my soul. And to free me, given me righteousness, not by my own works, but by the blood of Jesus.
Verse 8, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Father, thank you for allowing us to see your face, to come before you covered in the blood of the Lamb, called righteous, the righteousness of God, to be identified with the perfection, the fullness of the perfection that is in Christ, that you see us just the same. Father, thank you for the trials and the tribulations that we go through. For we know that these you are using to sanctify us, to bring us through the valley, God, where we walk with you as lambs, receiving your guidance and your correction, that we are made perfect and holy, God, without spot or blemish, God, that you teach us in those trials of who we are, that you're purifying us, sanctifying us, that you're breaking off the ways of the world, God, that you're knitting us closer and closer to your heart, that the suffering and the building of faith has a purpose. Father, we shall see you in full in the end, but right now we shall also see you in part, Lord, that we can see the light of your face, God, that you give us that privilege and that honor because of what Christ has done. That, Father, you invite us into your presence, God. God, and you teach us what it means to be sons of God. That you're teaching us identity. Lord, that even though we live in this world, that we are not of this world. That we have a new identity, that we are identified with Christ and we are called sons of God as Christ is called a son of God. That we share in that same glory, covered in his righteousness. And that we know by the scripture that our identity is to bring peace wherever we go. We thank you, God. And it's not by our own doing, God. It's in Christ. It's faith in Christ. It's new identities in Christ. We are a new creation. We will walk in the fullness of our identity, God. We thank you, Lord, for calling us into the light, calling us into your presence, God. That we can learn our identity as peacemakers, Lord. That we can learn, Lord, to listen to the Holy Spirit and walk in the infilling of the Holy Spirit, God. That here on the earth, you use us, Father, to bring peace. God, not by our own efforts, but God, because you are the Prince of Peace.
You are purifying, sanctifying, making me more like your. your Son, purify, sanctify, making me more like 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 your Son, Jesus. Oh, more like Jesus. As you have called me your Son to, let me live up to that name. As you purify, as you sanctify me, through trials, through hardships, through revealing of unclean parts of our heart, process bring you glory in the end. Let every messy process bring you glory in the end. Let every messy process bring you glory in the end. Let every messy process bring you glory in the end. You are pruning, purifying, sanctifying us. And in the midst of it all, we get to see you. We get to be with you. In the midst of it all, we get to see you. We still have access to you. That's what it means to be a son. That's what it means to be a son of God. That's what it means to be a son. That's what it means to be a son of God. That's what it means to be a son. That's what it means to be a son of God. Blessed
are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Father, we rejoice in the persecutions that we face on this earth. Father, when we submit God, to the persecutions that you allow us to go through, because it's for righteousness' sake. And we refuse, Father, to be like the people of this world who look at persecution, who look at suffering, and they give up and they stray, Father, and they fight one another and they toil. But Father, we know, we submit to the persecutions, Father, for righteousness' sake, for your kingdom's sake, Father, to be made perfect in righteousness in every way, to be more like Christ, for Christ to be exalted in our lives and around us, God, and we would much rather go through the persecution and endure to the end for righteousness' sake, so that we can inherit the kingdom of heaven. God, use us as tools, use us as vessels of honor for your kingdom to be established in our midst. Yeah, we thank you for the promise, for the purpose, for the glory and the joy that you offer us so freely, that in joy you gave us this preaching, Jesus, as you were on the earth, because you knew the suffering that your people would go through, that it wouldn't be easy. And you left us your words of promise because you knew what was at the end, that the kingdom of heaven would be ours and that we would inherit the earth. Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
blessed are we when we face trials, when we face persecution. Sharing the sufferings of Christ, we fellowship in the sufferings of Christ. Let us not fear, let us not fear,
Father, thank you for teaching us who we are by your word, that you did not leave us as orphans, but as a good father, you left us your teaching. Father, you gave us your Holy Spirit, who continues to comfort us and to sanctify us and teach us, and day by day we are transformed into the image of your Son. Thank you for your promises in Christ. Each one of them are yes and amen, and we receive the kingdom of heaven. We receive comfort. We receive the inheritance of the earth. We receive all of your promises, God. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. At this time, we will transition to a time of intercession for Israel. Psalm 122, verse 6 tells us to pray for the peace of Israel. So at K1, we are faithful to do this and to intercede for the nation of Israel. And so I encourage you to seek God's heart for this nation that God is so faithful to. As I cover the prayer points and intercede, I encourage you to join your faith and intercede with me. Father, we pray for peace for Israel at its borders. That, Father, they are surrounded by people who are at enmity with them. Father, we pray for peace and for protection. That you would protect the women and children and the men, Father, who live around those borders, God. Who live under the threat of war. Father, that you would be with them, that you are the hope to the hopeless. Father, we pray, Lord, for Syria, that's to the north of Israel's border. God, they're experiencing just internal warfare at this time. There are a lot of victims of chemical warfare. And Father, we pray, Lord, that Israel would be a blessing to Syria as well and to its other neighbors. That, Father, that they would be a vessel of peace. Father, a light upon a hill. That, Father, that there would be peace around its borders, Lord. We proclaim that God is Israel's keeper, watches over the city, that it does not fear. Father, that it is not a country that is left unprotected, but God, you watch over Israel. day and night, God, that you're faithful to your promises. So we thank you, Father, for hearing our prayer, God, and being so faithful to watch over the city, to watch over the nation, God, and to bring peace and protection to its borders, Lord. Let's pray. Father, we prophesy over Israel that Israel has a good future, a future of peace. Father, we don't look to the present circumstances that may, just to the present circumstances that we may see or hear on the news, God, or what people say, because we know, God, that you are at work in Israel. For her good and not for her harm. For her peace and for her well-being. And we prophesy, God, that this same witness would be in the hearts of the people. That Israel has a good future. Because God is the God over Israel. That God, you are forever and ever the God of Israel. And that does not change because of your faithfulness. And you will be the guide of Israel until the very end. Father, we trust in your faithfulness. That, Father, that even when people are unfaithful in Israel, God, that you are faithful. And we pray, Father, for a turning of hearts so that Israel can receive every gift that God has prepared. That Israel will come into the full inheritance. Will receive Jesus as her Messiah, so that he can establish his throne. We pray, Father, that hearts will continue to heed God's sound judgment and find peace. Would not follow after the ways of this world, would not be distracted, but would heed your sound judgment that is laid out in your word, God. That they would listen to the promises of God and to hear your heart of love, which desires to bless them and bring them into safety. That your promises are good and true until the very end, Lord. Let's pray. Father, we pray for peace in their battle and for a supernatural awakening by your Holy Spirit to know that the battle around them is spiritual. For our war is not with flesh, and blood. That even as they suffer physical attack throughout many generations around their borders, God, may there be a spiritual alertness, that there is an undergirding spiritual evil under everything, that their true enemy is the forces of darkness, that they may rightly equip themselves to fight the battle, to fight the spiritual battle. For we know, Father, that our war is not with flesh and blood, and the weapons that we fight with are not javelin, sword, and spear. And David knew this. And so he was confident to depend on you, God, to cry out to you, because he knew that in his own strength, he was not supposed to fight the enemy, but it was the power of God. And so we pray for this same spiritual awakening, alertness to be in Israel, God, for an awakening to the spiritual battle that goes on in Israel against the Israeli people, that they would be awakened to fight this spiritual battle, Lord, to tear down strongholds, lies of the enemy, traps of the enemy that have been placed there. Father, we tear them down in the name of Jesus. And we declare that Israel is free from the works of the enemy, that Israel belongs to El Shaddai, that as the church of God, that we also will pray against the forces of darkness that are against Israel, your people, God. That the veil of darkness would be torn away, that they may see Christ, the true Messiah, who has come to save. And Father, we pray that Israel will see God, really see God, because he's the one who brings victory, and that he never fails. Father, we declare, as it says in Psalm 44, verse 3, that it's God's right hand and the light of his face that delivered the nation of Israel, because God loves them, because you love them. Let's pray. Father, your scripture foretells of Christ. It says, gird your sword upon your side, O mighty one. Clothe yourself with splendor and majesty. In your majesty, ride forth victoriously in behalf of truth, humility, and righteousness. Let your right hand display awesome deeds. Father, we pray that prophecies like this about Christ, there would be a revelation in Israel, God, that they tell of Jesus Christ as the coming King, the King of Israel. God, that the veil would be torn away, that as people look to you, God, that they would see Christ for who he really is. We prophesy that truth, humility, and righteousness to be established in the communities where Christ is being exalted as King in Israel. That, Father, that these communities, God, who know the truth, who proclaim Christ as the Messiah, that these communities, these ministries in Israel, these families, these individuals, God, who know Christ, that they would carry the powerful ministry of repentance and the kingdom of heaven like John the Baptist, that you would make people, make them the influencers of their community, God, that they would carry a powerful anointing, Lord, to speak the truth, to proclaim truth, God, that they don't go in their own strength, but they carry the anointing of the Most High to speak this truth, God, and that truth would transform their communities, God, that these communities would be founded in strength and stability, Father, in anointing, God, that their communities would be established in your truth, that your peace would be established in those places, God, and that those places, Father, would be vessels of your peace, Lord. That there would be an anointing upon them. The anointing of your Holy Spirit, Lord, who brings truth and conviction, who brings revelation of Scripture. We thank you, Lord, for this powerful anointing upon these ministries and these communities, God, that they would be strengthened in your truth. Yes, Lord, that they would be strengthened and established in your peace, in your presence, that even in the midst of opposition and persecution, they would not be shaken, but established in your peace. That they should not be found in want, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs. We thank you, Lord. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to be in your presence and to dig into your word, to really walk in the fullness of what your word says, of the identity that it teaches us. God, and we thank you for the opportunity, the privilege to pray for Israel, God, that we know your heart for Israel because of the word of God, and that we can look into your heart and to use scripture to pray for Israel, Lord. God, so we thank you, Lord, for tonight, for the opportunity to be here with you, Lord, and to just draw closer to you, Lord.